How to create your first application? How to design modern apps easily and efficiently? Hi, I'm Gaurav from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to create our very first application with the help of Flutterflow. In case you guys don't know what is Flutterflow, it's a very powerful platform for building mobile apps easily and efficiently. We are going to create our application by using Flutterflow Designer Studio and using all the elements which are present there. Also, we are going to implement some actions there. So let's start. First, go to your browser and search Flutterflow, and here log in into your account. Here in the dashboard, on the top right, click create new. Name your application. I will name it my app. As you can see, there are plenty of pre-built templates. You can use that if you want. Here we are going to create our app from scratch, so we are going to take a blank template here. Here you can select your theme, and on the bottom you can see set up Firebase. For now, keep this toggle off because we are going to create our screen for now, and click on start building. So here is your app designing studio. On the middle you have the canvas on which you will see how your app will look. On the right side is your properties panel, and on the left side you can see many elements there which are known as widgets. In Flutterflow, all the elements that we use are called as widgets. So when I click here, this is our widget tree, and here is our home page, and below is our elements that are present in our home page. For now, I will just click here and delete here. So in our home page, we are going to create a sign up screen here. And as we know, for a sign up screen, we need three text fields, which are email, password, and confirm password. So we will create that. But before that, we need to create an attractive background. So for that, here I will take a container widget here. Now I want my container to cover the entire screen. So here in our properties, I will select width to 100% and height also will be 100%. As you can see, our container is covering the entire screen except some part from the top and bottom. If you want the container to cover that too, for that, here click on your home page and you can turn off the safe area. Now our container has covered the entire screen. Now below you can see, you can change the color of your background like that. But what if I want to set an image in my background? In Flutterflow, setting the image in the background is too easy. Here below, you can see the option background image, and here the network. Even if you want to upload, you can upload your file, and in the assets, you can upload your file too. But as I have a URL already, I will just copy that and paste it here. Now our screen has a beautiful background. So our background is set. Now we want to add three text fields here. But we need our text fields to be in a vertical fashion. So for that, we need a column. So here I will create a column widget here, and in the column, I will add a text field like that. Now add another text field here and one more like that. As you can see, our text field is on the top. What if I want it on the middle? For that, just click on your column, and here in the main axis alignment, you can align it here. Now we have our text field, but we need some spacing between them. Now here are our text field, but they are very close to each other. So what if I want to give a space to them? For that, here in our column widget, in the properties, I will add the item spacing of 30 here. Easy. Now name your text field. First will be our email, and in the hint text, I will add enter your email. Also, I want to decorate my text box a little bit. For that, I will give it a border color here. And I will give it a focus border color. So I will get the idea when I will enter the field. I will give it a focus border color here, so that whenever I will enter the text here, I will see the blue color. Also, let's increase the border radius 20. Same in our password field. It will be our password. And in the hint text, I will write enter your password. Same for the border color, I will give it primary text, and the focus border color will be secondary, and the border radius will be 20. Now, here our confirm password field. In the hint text, I will write confirm your password. Here will be confirm your password. Same with the border color. Here and focus border color will be secondary. Next, the border radius will be 20. So you saw how easily we created our text field and our app design. Now let's add a button here and add an action to it. For that, I will click on my column again. And here I will select button, and I will name this button as create account name. It here, let's give it a color like that and give it a border radius. Now we want to create our app a little more attractive. For that, in our column, add another column here and move your widgets in this column and wrap it in a container. Give it an item spacing like before and give the container a width of 80% and a height of 55% and align these in the middle like before. Now let's give it a color like that. And we will give it like that. And after that, we will give our container a border radius of 25. Also, let's add a label text, move it on the top. Here, I will write my app. Let's increase its font size 32 and a font weight and a color. It looks a little ugly. Let's make it a little better. Now our screen design is ready, so let's create an action here. For that, I will create a new page. I will select create blank and I will name it new page. Name it new page. And here, when I click add the action, navigate to new page. So we have added our action here. Let's add a back button here in our app bar, like that. So we have added our action, so let's test it in our testing mode. But note, before testing here, please select your entry page, as our default is our home page. Now for testing, here I will click on the top right. Before starting our testing mode, Flutterflow loads all the necessary packages which are required for loading our app in the test mode. It takes at least 2 to 3 minutes. As you can see, here is our testing mode. Here is our instant reload, and here is our time in which our test session will expire. Now, when I click here, I will enter my email. And here I will enter my password. And when I click here, here I am navigated to our new page. But have you saw that we have created two password fields, but still I can see it like a normal text field. So for making it like a password field, just go to your design studio. And here on the properties, turn on the password field option, and add the icon size to 24. Same for this one, icon size 24. Now we have set it, so we don't have to create another test session here. We just need to click on instant reload and our changes will be reflected. Now, as you can see, we have our password field, and if I enter, it is looking like a password field. Now, in our enter password and confirm password, before navigating, we want an action to check whether our confirm password is equal to the entered password. For that, we will click here and open our navigation flow. We will remove that. We will add a conditional action and we'll select the single condition. And here I will select my widget state. First will be our password field equal to our confirm password field. Then navigate to new page. And if it's false, show a message. Select show snack bar fields and I will show the message not matched. And here I will select the background color to be red. Now click on instant reload. Now if I enter my email and I will intentionally add different password, here I am getting not matched. Oops, it's not here. Let's improve it and click on instant reload again. Enter email. Here I am getting the error not matched. And if I enter the same password, I am navigated to the new page. So you saw how easy it was to design your application in Flutter Flow. So in this video, we learned how to create our application in Flutter Flow. Also, we created our modern design with the help of Flutter Flow designer elements known as widgets and implemented actions. Also, we used conditional actions too. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your IT source. We are always there to help you navigate to the tech world. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. So stay curious and keep learning.